you define beautiful?
Beautiful is, I'd say a girl that's beautiful is tall and fun to be around. I don't know.
Oh.
Like a nice teeth and a good smile. It's beautiful.
When you're coming right out of 1716, there's a group of girls just walking right in front of you, and you see those legs, and you see those calf muscles, they go all the way up. You know exactly. She's the one.
Beauty isn't skin deep. It's more the personality and how you act, not depending on who's around you, that it's like constant the whole entire time.
I think people's differences make people beautiful.
Do you think beauty trends are becoming more globalized?
Yes, I do, because I think the media has made people more image conscious.
Yes, actually, as a matter of fact, I use the Dead Sea mineral oils on my fingernails.
I do think that beauty trends are becoming more globalized. I think it has a lot to do with increase in immigration and acceptance of other cultures into this culture. I'm not saying that personally I think I have a global perspective on beauty and beauty trends, but I do see it in my environment, and I think that's becoming commonplace and accepted.
I do, because I think different countries have different techniques to offer that we can use in America that are just as good, if not better.
Globalization, the blending of cultures to create a more homogeneous view globally.
It's one way to take another person's beauty for yourself. See this woman's hair? It's real. Just not really hers.
You can have long hair now, one day.
Our crowning glory is more bejeweled than ever. Some of the world's most alluring women share one trait: long, thick, beautiful hair. A few admit to adding a little something extra. Most don't. But today's style icons are sending a very clear message. Hair is in. Subbayama has come with her entire family.
Lord Venkateshwar is our favorite god.
Like so many worshippers, she brought the god a very special offering. Her hair.
We feel happy if we shave our heads and very peaceful. All of our problems will vanish.
It's part of a ritual called tonsuring, the cutting of hair for religious reasons. Every day, thousands of Hindus sit before the temple barbers and a straight razor to offer their hair and please the god. For the temple, this has created a divine business model, as a hot commodity is donated by the tons. So they sell it to companies that process much of it for hair extensions. It's an $18 million a year business. Temple officials say the profits are then used to bless others by funding charity programs. A world away, their offering is happily accepted. Beauty sacrificed by one to be taken up by another.
Beauty rituals that were once localized to a specific culture are now becoming globalized.
Call it beauty without borders. The ancient beauty regimens of the people of India are threading their way into the spas and salons in the U.S.
When you are doing threading, the friction is not that much, and it's very good for sensitive skin.
Hair removal is a key component of personal care in India. Eyebrow threading involves no wax, no plucking, and no razors. Ayurvedic massage is a centuries-old system of healing using herb-infused oil.
So the nervous system has no choice but to relax.
As with threading and sugaring, it's all natural.
And a healthy body is a beautiful body, so if you're healthy, it's going to show, and you're going to have beautiful, healthy hair and beautiful, healthy skin. Like, it's going to show itself that way, and that's where the beauty comes from.
A holistic approach to beauty, which could alter our habits here in America, one person at a time.
When a young woman hits puberty and is ready to marry, these scars help her to become more attractive to the men in the tribe. Potential suitor claims that the scar patterns are beautiful to look at and to touch. Some may also see women who are willing to undergo the pain and suffering of this practice to be fit and strong enough to undergo the pains of childbirth. Ear and lip stretching is a form of body piercing, but unlike the traditional piercing where jewelry is merely set in the opening, stretching of the ear or lip is gradually increased with each year and larger plates are inserted. These plates are usually made of clay, wood, stone, bone, or metal. This tradition of African tribes is slowly coming to an end in the 20th century. The Surma and Mercy people in Ethiopia still make use of this practice. However, the girls of Mercy are deciding whether they want to wear lip plates or not. According to the Encyclopedia of Body Adornment, lip plates are usually no longer than 3 centimeters in width, but the women in southern Chad wear extremely large plates, often as large as 24 centimeters. Also, the plates are worn by women for decoration purposes, and, much like the standard body piercing, the sizes are important for social status. Simply put, in these tribes, women who wear their lip plates are seen as being more beautiful than the women without them. In America today, many of these modifications have become popular in the younger generations. Piercing, stretching, scarring, and teeth filing are among the most popular. However, in American culture, unlike Africa, these adornments are done mainly for decorational and sexual purposes.
Most Japanese mothers, typical mothers, they want their daughters to have white porcelain skin. So one day I remembered what my mother said to me about nightingale droppings.
I can't wait to tell my husband that I had poop in my face.
My mother told me that how people, you know, like the kabuki actors and the geisha, they used and they couldn't remove those makeup easily. I'm sure that they tried everything, and then one day they tried those bird poops, I guess, and then it clean, you know, cleansed.
Is the price of beauty worth it? At the age of 23, the Hills star Heidi Montag has undergone 10 plastic surgeries in the pursuit for the perfect body. Many Americans and celebrities are becoming so obsessed with maintaining their idea of beauty, they become unrecognizable. In addition, the constant pressure to be thin leads 8 million Americans to have an eating disorder. The mortality rate associated with anorexia nervosa is 12 times higher than the death rate of all causes of death for females 15 to 24 years old. Shockingly, over half the females between the ages of 18 and 25 would prefer to be run over by a truck than be fat. Although painful, tattoos, once localized to specific regions or cultures, have now become a broad sense of beauty and are accepted worldwide. Even Barbie, the symbol of perfection and beauty, now sports a tattoo. But then again, is it really worth it? Although beautiful, these procedures also carry high risks. How far are you willing to go to be beautiful? Globalization has allowed us to view beauty in various ways. Regardless of shape, size, or procedures you go through, everyone is beautiful in their own way.
Beautiful girls all over the world. I could be chasing, but my time would be wasted. They got nothing on you, baby.
Yeah.
Nothing on you.
Nothing on you, babe. Nothing on you.
They might say hi, and I might say hey, but you shouldn't worry about what they say, 'cause they got nothing on you, baby.
Yeah.
Nothing on you.
Nothing on you, babe. Nothing on you.